The plan to have a cable car connecting West Jerusalem to the area of the Western Wall up to the Mount of Olives has been spoken about for a number of years. I found a headline in The Guardian way back, I think in 2007, which indicated how to get to the old city without seeing Palestinians. So from the very beginning, people had an idea about what this was about. And over the last couple of years, there have been serious feasibility studies with engineering firms, both domestic and international, planning the precise route of this. So this is no longer a fantasy. This is becoming an operational plan. There are a number of stakeholders here. There are the official ones and there are the unofficial ones. This is a plan that is being sponsored by the Jerusalem municipality, and it very much fits into the approach of Mayor Barakat, which is often the Disneyfication of Jerusalem, turning Jerusalem into some sort of Disney franchise theme park, in this case a pseudo-biblical theme park. There are strong indications that there's involvement of the settler organizations, and it clearly serves their purposes. The settlers have a penchant for meeting Palestinians underground in tunnels, above ground on roofs. Now we're taking it one level higher, and we will passing over them in cable cars. When the press approached the Director General for the Ministry of Jerusalem Affairs, Dvir Kahana, he said that he has not been dealing with this issue because of the potential conflict of interest that he has given his previous positions with the Allied Settler Organization. So there's apparently some sort of involvement there. Another indication of that is that the plan will be filed formally only after the settlement complex, the massive complex to be built at Kedem on the Givati parking lot between Dung Gate and Wadi Khilwa, City of David, is approved. Now that could be a couple of months from now, but it's also an indication how the settler schemes and this so-called government scheme are dovetailing. Now, those are not the only stakeholders. This plan will traverse very sensitive church properties, and there are a number of church groups that are involved. It will have a spur that goes down to the vicinity of Gethsemane, although not apparently Gethsemane itself. And in addition to that, it will pass very closely to the ramparts of the old city, in close proximity to Al-Aqsa Mosque. And obviously the Jordanians and the Waqf will have something to say about that. Finally, there's a stakeholder that is mentioned in none of the planning documents which I've seen. This will pass over privately owned Palestinian homes in Silwan. Part of the motivation is clearly bring up the numbers of tourists, because obviously Jerusalem is a tourist site. I think that that degrades the city, viewing it predominantly in that way. There are clearly the political motivations. Jerusalem is as divided today, in 2015, more divided than ever it was since 1967. And there's this belief that you can unite Jerusalem with gimmicks. And we are going to allow ourselves to enter this state of clinical denial that we are living in an emphatically binational city by flying over them. And they, from a safe distance, will look very quaint and pastoral. All of this is geared to radically transform the nature of the area surrounding the old city, which remains 47, 48 years after the war in 1967, remains largely Palestinian. West Jerusalem, the old city, the Western Wall, City of David, what we call Wadi Khilwa, Mount of Olives, and the visual basin of the old city, all of that comes out of the same culture of an exclusionary Jewish possessive claim to this area that's informed by biblical narratives. I have been trying to stop bad schemes in Jerusalem for the last 24 years, and the list of my failures are legion, okay? And the number of successes are few and far between. Having said that, I believe that this plan is stoppable because it is just so outrageous from so many different perspectives, from those for whom the integrity of the old city and the visual basin are so important, for faith communities. Can you imagine putting an ice skating rink next to St. Peter's Square in Rome because it will increase the number of pilgrims and worshipers who are going to visit the Holy See?